Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to another Qpython 3 tutorial. Now, one thing about this video today that I'm going to show you guys how to use functional arguments from the basics. Now, in the next tutorial, I'll be talking to you guys how to use it based on default parameters. But in this video, I'm going to be giving you guys a brief introduction to functional arguments. So, without much wasting time, let's get to business. Now, a functional argument is basically a parameter used inside a function. Now, previously in the last tutorial, I showed you guys how to make functions or how to define functions precisely. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to use arguments with functions. Now, in the last tutorial, I just made a function that's going to print out whatever utility prints out. Every time you call the function, with just the text and the parameter, sorry, the parentheses. But in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make functions that you can actually tell to print out whatever you want to print out from the function end. So this is much talk. I don't want to stress you guys with this talk. So let's just head to the tutorial. Now, to make a function with an argument or a parameter, you just simply use the def, that's to define the function. Then you just write out the name of function. Name of the function. So I'm going to call this function print out. Now basically this function is going to help me print out text, just a simple function. But something different from this one and the last tutorial is that this one is actually going to print out the text you give to it to print out from the function. So this function is going to take three arguments. Now let's call the first one name. That is very rough typing. Let's call the first one the name, the second one, let's say grade, and the third one should be something like, let's just say age. So basically this function is going to ask you for your name, your age, and a grade. So what we're going to do is that we're going to tell it to print out something like, let's say, my name is, then just do it, then I think, to add a comma and just say name, and the next line should be print let's say I am in grade let's just give it the grade, and we should not forget our comma. That should do it. Now this third line we're going to be printing out since we're giving it the age, let's just say I am, and then close this up, add the comma, then print out the age, and this time we're going to add the years old over this end. So basically, this is going to ask for your age, the grade you are, and how your name is or what's your name, and just rub it in your face over this function. So let's just deal with this and let's call out the function name. So we're going to call out print out. I think we should just change this function name to about me. So about me, and this should just deal with me. So this is basically about me, so I need to change this also, obviously, and this is good. So let's just save this and let's run. So remember, the name comes first, the grade goes second, and of course the age goes third. Now if I run this way, it will give me an error that says that it takes in three arguments but zero were given. Let's see. Okay, it says about me takes exactly three arguments and zero were given. This means that since you've created a function that takes argument, you must give in the arguments, or you must specify the arguments inside this parentheses. So what you have to do now is that you need to call in the name, the grade, and the age. So what is my name? So I'm gonna say my name is Desmond. Let's just put the parentheses here and say best nigga ever. Yeah, I'm black. Deal with it. Okay, so this is my name, and in the second place, let's just go straight to the grade. So I am in grade, let's give it something freaky. I am in grade 76. It's my grade, deal with it. And I am immortal, so I am 2,000 years old. Okay. That's my age. Deal with that also. So deal with about me. This is the function. This is it right here. So I have to run my function. I pray this does not give me any errors because I don't know where I'll correct it from. Okay, yeah, it says my name is Desmond, best nigga ever. I am in grade 76. I am 2,000 years old. So taking back and referencing this, all of this to the function we created, it means that this is the name, taking the first argument in this function, and this is the grade, taking the second argument position in this function, and this is my age, which takes in the third argument position in this function. Now this video is getting kind of long, so I don't want to stress you guys with all this, but please be sure to subscribe to this channel, like this video, share, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Thank you all for watching. It's Desmond. See you guys next time.